Hello everyone and welcome to Let's Learn English Online. Today we are going to discuss the short form of important phrasal verbs starting with A. So let's get started. Question comes in our mind that what is a phrasal verb? According to Merriam-Webster's dictionary, it is a phrase that combines a verb with a preposition or adverb or both, and which functions as a verb whose meaning is different from the combined meaning of the individual words, such as take off and look down on. Our first phrasal verb is abide by, which means to respect or to obey any specific law, decision or a rule. We can also use them in a sentence. For example, if John wants to stay in this college, then he must abide by the rules. Here we can easily understand the use of abide by in a sentence. Hence, this sentence is giving complete sense of the phrasal verb. See the second one here, which is account for. It means to give a reason or an explanation. We can use it in sentence as, I hope Sarah can account for all the money she had used for her lavish parties. Let's observe the third phrasal verb here, which is at for. It means to want something very much or very badly. Observe the example of sentence construction. He was so lonely that he asked for the sound of a human voice. Hence, we can easily understand the function and the meaning of this phrasal verb. Let's discuss the fourth phrasal verb here, which is act on. It means to take action as a result of something. Observe the sentence construction here. The police decided to act on the anonymous call they received yesterday. So it is clear that act on means to take action due to the result of something. Let's move towards our fifth phrasal verb, which is act out. Act out means to demonstrate something with gestures and actions. Observe the sentence construction for better understanding. The students acted out the drama scene in the classroom. Here, acted out means that to perform practically, to perform physically. So it is clear through this example. Let's move towards our sixth phrasal verb, which is act up. Act up means to cause pain or annoyance by functioning badly. Hence, it can be the pain due to the result of some bad functioning. Observe the example of sentence construction. Here, Alina's poor knee is acting up again. It means that Alina might have knee pain that is acting up again, that is causing pain in very bad way. Let's move towards our seventh phrasal verb, which is add up. Add up means to make sense or seem reasonable. Observe the sentence construction here. She explained what happened, but the details she gave just don't add up. It means that the sentence means that what the girl has explained about the specific happening through her details doesn't make any sense or doesn't seem reasonable. So let's move towards our eighth phrasal verb, which is adhere to. Adhere to means to support, follow or act in accordance with. Observe the following example here. All contestants must adhere to the rules. As you can easily understand the meaning of adhere to in this sentence construction, that all contestants must follow the rules of their specific game or something. Now let's move towards our ninth phrasal verb, which is advise against. Advise against means recommend not to do something. Hence, its meaning is clear and it will be further clear through the use of sentence making. The doctor advised him against carrying heavy loads. Here, advised him against carrying heavy loads is easily understandable that doctor is not allowing the patient to carry heavy loads. Let's discuss our 10th phrasal verb, which is agree with. Agree with means have the same opinion as someone else. Let's observe the construction of the sentence. The teacher agreed with the students and decided to go on a trip with them. Here, the teacher has agreed with the students that they were forcing her, or they were making a plan so that she can go with them to a specific picnic. So here the phrasal verb agree with is acting and further enhancing the meaning. So with the use of this sentence, we can easily understand the agree with means having the same opinion as someone else. So the teacher is having the same opinion as students and all of them were going to on a trip. Let's move towards our 11th phrasal verb, which is aim at. Aim at means direct towards a target or to attack towards a target. Observe the sentence here. The policeman aimed his gun at the hijacker. It means that policeman was aiming through his guns at the hijacker, meaning he was directed towards his target. So let's move towards our 12th phrasal verb, which is allow for. Allow for means take into consideration, include in a calculation. Observe the example here. We must allow for food expenses in the picnic as well. Let's add $20 per person. Here allow for is working to mean take into consideration the food expenses or include the calculation of food expenses, and then further the meaning is coming out quite clear that let's add $20 per person. Hence the meaning of allow for is clear here. Let's move towards our 13th phrasal verb, which is allude to. Allude to means to mention or make reference to something in an indirect way. Observe the example here. I don't understand the problem she was alluding to during the conversation. So the phrasal verb alluding to is giving the meaning that that specific person did not understand the problem that a specific girl was mentioning him about in an indirect way through her conversation. Hence the meaning is clear that allude to means to mention or to make reference to something in an indirect way, not in a clear way. Let's move towards our 14th phrasal verb, which is amount to. Amount to means being equivalent to reach a specific point. Observe the example here. His statement amounted to a confession. Means the statement a specific person made led to a confession, was equivalent to a confession he made. Observe the second example here. To reach a specific point, the total repair work will amount to $1,200. Here the total repair of work will reach a specific amount of $1,200. Hence the meaning is clear. Let's move towards the 15th phrasal verb, which is angle for. Angle for means try to obtain something by hinting or suggesting. From the way of his speaking, I suspect Tom was angling for a free ticket. It means that the way of speaking of Tom was helpful in suggesting or hinting to acquire a free ticket. Let's move towards our 16th phrasal verb, which is answer back. Answer back means to reply rudely to someone in authority when you are expected to remain silent. Answer back is a quite easy phrasal verb. Let's use it in our sentence construction, which says don't answer back to your teacher. Hence its use is clear that answering back or to replying rudely to a teacher would be considered as bad manner or as ill-mannered thing. So answer back means to reply rudely to someone in authority when you are expected to remain silent. Hence, its meaning is clear. Let's move towards our 17th phrasal verb, which is answer for. Answer for means to be held responsible for something. When someone will be responsible for something, or we will say that he has to answer for it. For example, normally parents have to answer for their children's behavior. Hence, its meaning is quite clear. Let's move towards our second meaning of answer for, which is to speak on behalf of someone. Observe the example here. I agree to your proposal, but I can't answer for my associate. Means that specific person has agreed to a specific proposal, but he can't answer, or he can't answer on behalf of his associate. Hence, its meaning is completely clear here. Observe the 18th phrasal verb here, answer to, which means be responsible to or be controlled by someone. So, who do you answer to in your job means by whom you are controlled or who is your boss. I hope it is clear now. So, this is it for today. See you in the next video. Just stay tuned with Let's Learn English Online for more informative videos.